Hello everyone, so today we'll be continuing our Python tutorial series. And today we'll be talking about arithmetic operators. So here's the list of all the arithmetic operators in Python: addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, modulus, exponentiation, and floor division. And at the end of the video, we'll be talking something interesting about modulus operator. So let's see how all these operator works. 5 plus 6 gives 11, addition operator, 5 minus 6. Gives minus 1, subtraction operator, 8 multiply by 6, that is asterisk sign, is used for multiplication, gives 48, 8 divided by 6 gives 1.3338, 8 floor division 6 gives 1. So the difference between this and this is that if we want a float value of division, we apply single slash. And if we want an integer value after division, so we apply two slash. And now exponentiation, this stands for 8 raised to the power 3. So these two signs stands for raised to the power 3. The answer is 512, and we can recheck by doing 8 multiplied by 8 multiplied by 8 gives the same number. So now in the end, we'll be talking about modulus. So this gives us the remainder. So if we divide 8 by 6, the remainder will be 2. So the interesting part is, what if we divide minus 8 by 6? Our remainder will be 4. But that's not the answer we expected. So let's see what's going on here. So now let's take a look at this example. If we divide a negative number by a positive number, the remainder will be positive. It's because the sign of the remainder will be the same as of that of the divisor. So here divisor is positive, so the remainder will also be positive. So let's take this example as, if you are filling a bucket whose depth is the magnitude of the dividend, that is minus 7, and we have to fill it with bricks, and the magnitude of one brick is equal to the value of divisor. So if we start filling this bucket, one brick fills 3 values, 2 brick fills 6 values, and the last brick, 1 value is used to fill the basket and 2 values are overflowed. So this is a remainder, and the sign will be positive because the divisor was positive. Now let's take a look at the next example. In this, positive number is divided by a negative number, so our divisor is negative, so now we have got negative remainder. It's same as the last case. 3 values filled by 1 brick, 6 by 2, 9 values are filled by 3rd brick, so 1 value is used to fill the bucket and other 2 are overflowed, but this time on the negative side of the number line, so the value is negative, remainder is negative. Now what if both the dividend and divisor are negative? We divide minus 7 by minus 3, so we apply the same rule, that minus sign for divisor, so minus sign for remainder. So what we do in this case, in order to maintain the same sign, we fill up the basket only until the negative sign doesn't change. That is, the basket should not overflow. So we fill 1 brick, 3 values are filled, 2 brick, 6 values are filled, and we cannot add another brick because the basket will be overflowed and the sign will be positive. But we have to maintain the negative sign as the divisor is negative. So we have 1 unit shortfall in this example to fill the basket. So the answer will be minus 1. So this is how modulus operator works with the negative signs. So that's it for this video. If you have any question, write it in the comment section. And the next video we'll be discussing about variables and strings. Thank you.